Hello, this is Mark Wildman of Wildman Athletica, and today we are going to talk about exercises for overweight individuals, specifically walking. There's a lot of advice that people get when they're trying to move from overweight or deconditioned or recovering from injury back towards being more functional so that they can start doing more hardcore types of athletic training. Usually, the thing that we focus on first is structure. We want people to learn to stand up well, because if you're deconditioned or injured or heavier than you would like to be, then you tend not to stand all the way up. And that makes everything very, very stressful because everything's a lot harder than it needs to be because of the compromise of joint angle. In the beginning, we tend to work with single arm club training because it can help us learn to point our feet straight ahead, put our knees under our hips, and learn to stand all the way up by having people focus on rotation. Inside rotation, outside rotation with left and right hand because everybody's got a bad side, and our shield cast, which causes people to stand all the way up so that we are no longer in a hunched over position or a rounded position. We're making it easier for our body to stand all the way up later and to breathe. Also, we have our other series, suitcase deadlift, holding a weight on one side, standing all the way up, learning to stand up. Box squat, where we sit down on an object, pick our feet up, rock forward, stand all the way up, stand up, and press. We have that exercise when we learn to press that forces us to try to stand all the way up and get away from this type of position and back towards standing all the way up. These two things are very controllable. We can start with a very light weight and we can build it up over time as we build the experience in order to do it better. Start with a light weight so you don't get hurt, build experience. Worry less about burning a lot of calories, worry more about standing all the way up and getting better structure so you can move on to other things. Then we move towards walking for time for most people. Everybody tells everybody to just go for a walk every day. Nobody tells you how to go for a walk every day. We're gonna tell you how to go for a walk every day. This one benefits very highly from either a watch with an interval timer on it or any countdown timer or any smartphone on the planet. You'll be able to set a timer and walk down from it. You have those timers on your phone. You can set a timer for 2 minutes and 30 seconds. That's all we need in the beginning. I don't care if you start with 30 seconds. I want you to go to your front door or wherever you're gonna walk, and I want you to walk away from your house for 30 seconds. When the bell goes off, I want you to turn around and I want you to walk home. We're only gonna control the time away from your front door. We are not gonna control the time on the way back. Oftentimes people will walk a lot faster going home. This is something that I learned when training horses when I was young. You can ride away from the barn for a very long time and the horse will always shave 30% off the time to get back home. So we only control the time out. Humans are exactly the same. You will walk away from your front door for time. We do not want you to walk so far that you get exhausted and you get sore and then you don't want to do it the next day. We would rather you start with a very small period of time. 30 seconds out, bell goes off, you turn around, you go back. You could do that for a week, you could do it for a day before you add more time. And then you're going to go up to walk away for 1 minute, walk back for however long it takes, walk out for a minute and a half, walk back, walk out for 2 minutes, walk back, walk out for 2.5 minutes, walk back. If you get to the point where you're walking out for 15 minutes, then you're going to walk back for 15 minutes-ish, and you have now accomplished a 30-minute walk. We have done it in super, super, super small steps. If you are deconditioned, externally rotated feet, collapsed arches, or anything like that, then you do not want to just go out and walk for 30 minutes. Because your feet will hurt, your knees will hurt, your back will hurt, and you won't want to do it anymore. So you will instantly learn to not do it. That is not the point. We are trying to get you to learn to succeed instead of learn to fail. So make the starting point as small as it has to be. 30 seconds is fine, a minute is fine, 2 minutes is fine. You're gonna have to experiment to figure out which one it is, but always err on the side of starting very, very, very short. If you added 30 seconds a week, if you went out for a walk 5 days and you walked out for 2 minutes and you walked back, you would do 4 minutes. Next week, you would walk out for 2.5 minutes and you would come back. In short order, within 6 months, you're going to be walking for 30 minutes out and 30 minutes back. Within a year, you're going to be walking out for an hour out and an hour back, but you're going to build it up one step at a time, you're going to learn to succeed instead of learn to fail. You can do this as often as possible. I tell people don't go above 5 days a week because they do need to take those days to totally rest their body. And you should be doing single arm club, say 2 days a week, and then the other kettlebell or dumbbell program 2 days a week. Walking 5 days a week, now you're building a good strategy to get better at what you wanna do. You're building up your structure, and now you're gonna build up your ability to do the most fundamental human thing, stand up and then walk. We take it for granted that we should be really good at that, and people try to jump into really complex stuff really too soon, and that tends to be the problem, and then they learn that they fail, and then they stop doing it, which is not the goal. The goal is to learn to succeed always. Side effect is, you're learning to build in adventure training, walk a different direction every day, and you're learning to get back out and take over the world. I use this strategy overseas where I will walk away from my hotel in Morocco or anywhere you are in the world for 10 minutes and walk back. And then every day I will walk a different direction, and any road I've never been on is an adventure. It's a trick to make you want to walk more. It works pretty well. Give it a shot. And then we will continue to talk about this topic forever, because we can come up with good ideas for this forever.